So I'm here with Chris Todd from Brighton and Hove Friends of the Earth. Welcome back to latest TV news, Chris.
Thank you.
Lots going on in your neck of the woods, really, to do with the environment. But more importantly, there's the 10-year anniversary of the South Downs National Park. So tell us all about it, because I know that Hilary Benn, the MP, came along, didn't he, to
celebrate
it?
No, it's been a great celebration. We organised something in November when he actually, 10th anniversary, when he signed the confirmation order for the South Downs National Park. Unfortunately, we had a general election called and he wasn't able to make it. We've now had the plaque commemorating the signing installed on the Nutmeg Tree Cafe in West Street in Ditchling. And he was able to come down on Monday and sort of unveil the plaque. And I think it's a great moment. It's 10 years since we achieved the National Park status. It was a big, big campaign, not just in Brighton, but across the whole of the South East, and nationally as well.
Yeah.
Very, very popular with the public. And I think, you know, it's done a good job. It's established itself in 10 years, and it's had to do a lot of the sort of bureaucracy of setting up an organisation. But I think, you know, it can now look forward for the next 10, 20, 30 years with confidence that we've got a body there to champion the South Downs.
Yeah. How big is the South Downs National Park then?
Well, it's about 1,600 square kilometres. Right. It stretches from Eastbourne in the east through to Winchester in the west. But it doesn't just include the Chalk Hills. That's part of the big argument we had. It also includes the Western Weald and other areas of woodland over into Hampshire as well.
By and large, it's been successful and there's not been any development. I know there's been bits of it that they open up for development, but...
Well, I think, you know, it's not preserving something in aspic, so communities evolve, so there will be some development that happens.
Yeah.
The National Park really wants to focus on sort of providing housing for local people, so sort of social housing, but, you know, with the controls that you can keep it as social housing and it doesn't get sold off after 5 or 10 years and then you're in this constant cycle of having to keep building and building and building just to try and maintain some sort of social housing and keep, you know, sort of a variety, you know, within the community. So it's not just all retired people, but there are younger people, people with families who are able to live and afford to live and work in the National Park.
Yeah. Why did it take so long for it to be established? Because it's a no-brainer, isn't it, really? But it took a long time, didn't it? And some great work by yourself and others as well to get to that stage.
It took a ridiculously long time. And I think we have to say it was held up by vested interests along the way. I mean, it was first proposed in 1947.
Yeah.
Then the National Parks Act came in 1949 and it was looked to become a national park in the 1950s and 60s. But it was the landholding interests who scuppered it, basically. And we got given the second class designation as an area of outstanding natural beauty. But that wasn't enough because of the various pressures and then, you know, the groundswell of concern and opposition, you know, came up through the late 80s with a rising environmental awareness that happened around that time and then into the 90s. And we had all sorts of issues there which sort of really triggered concern and, you know, increased the pressure really for it to happen and pushed it into the national arena.
Yeah.
I think without that, it wouldn't have happened.
Yeah. So Hilary Benn, he was there because he was the Secretary of State, I think, for the environment. It was a big organisation, wasn't it DEFRA back then? It was a big one, but it was a mammoth department. So he was the guy that enacted, put it into...
Yeah, he got the inspector's report, he looked over it, and he made some actual changes. He was brave enough to make some changes, and he sort of looked and said, well, you know, there'd been a very strong case made for the inclusion of Ditchling, for example.
Exactly, yeah.
But the inspector had recommended it shouldn't be included because he said the landscape to the north wasn't of national park quality. Hilary Benn disagreed. He thought, you know, Ditchling summed up quintessentially what the South Downs is all about, thought the landscape around was high quality and, you know, put it in the national park along with some other places like Alice Holt Forest over in Hampshire. And that's, you know, he defined the final boundaries of the national park that we have today.
Yeah, Total Valley wasn't part of the final national park boundaries, but we know that the Green Ridge area just by Total Valley was part of it. So there was bits and pieces were put in and then out, and it was kind of the final boundaries. There was a discussion, wasn't there, took place?
It's, yeah, I mean, particularly around Brighton, it's yeah. very problematic. It's very complicated boundary, a very long boundary, going in and out all around all the sort of houses around Wolscombe, Beverdean, Rottingdean, yeah. Saltdean, you know, Port Slade, Hangleton, etc. By and large, we got most of the area of outstanding natural beauty yeah. that was included within the national park, so including bits at Four Down Tower, for example. There were sort of elements of Benfield Valley and Toadshole Valley, which were south of the bypass and quite disconnected at those points, which we weren't successful in getting in. But we got the landscape around Ovingdean and Rottingdean was included, and that previously, that big sweep yeah. around Red Hill, was not part of the AOMB.
Thanks, Chris, for coming in, and we'll catch up again soon, no doubt.
Okay. Cheers, thanks. Cheers, thanks.
Thanks.
Anyway, it gives me great pleasure to formally unveil this magnificent plaque to commemorate the signing of the order creating the South Downs National Park just over a decade ago. Oh, it's very splendid. Oh, I like that.